Well, have a good afternoon and welcome back here to the Imagine Cruising 2023 World Indoor Bowls Championships live from Potter's Resorts. Coming up next is another of the Ladies World Match Plays. It's Cerianne Glen who will face Julie Forrest. Let's have a look at what we have for the rest of today then. Well, the evening game at 7:30 is Alison Merrion MBE who will play Australia's Lisa Featherby. So let's have a look at our officials. Is Francis Fletcher is the marker, the umpire is Dan Blewett, and on the shot clock is Mike Davies. Let's go live to the portal rink, and a massive round of applause please for our MC, Mr. Jack Jenkins.
Thank you very much, Jason. Yes, welcome back to the International Arena here at Potter's Resorts. It's now time to bring out the players. First out this afternoon, we have a 7-time national indoor singles champion who was a previous world mixed pairs champion and 2-time former ladies match play world champion. Please put your hands together for Scotland's Julie Forrest. Her opponent is a former Commonwealth medalist with several Australian national medals to her name. She is also a former Ladies Match Play Trophy winner and next week is hoping to pick up her 3rd mixed pairs world title. From Wales, please put your hands together for Cerianne Glen. I will hand you up to Sean Honour and David Corkill in the commentary box.
Well, 2 very experienced players here. Cerianne Davis hasn't played for a long time. That was the name she was using when she was playing at the very top level. She's now Cerianne Glen. And instead of living in Wales, she's now living in Scotland. Julie Forrest, well known, of course, to the bowlers minutes. In the British Isles. 8-time national champion, British Isles champion, more times than anybody else, and also 2 winner of this event. Really has been the star of the last 20 years in the indoor circuit. Hasn't always done as well here in the portable rink as she would like, by her own admission, but she is still chasing more titles. Kerry responds to both Cerianne and to Kerry, so she says she doesn't mind either way. But of course we knew, we're so used to her as Davies rather than Glen. Married to Ian Glen, also a bowler. Julie Farris managed, she's married to Derek, who has absolutely nothing to do with bowls whatsoever. Very happy to support his wife. And why wouldn't you even play like that?
What a great start.
Kerry played a lot of bowls in Australia, very attacking player. That's a good effort. Good close ball.
2 green.
Julie's line 2. Not easy to add another one here. That was the benefit of the last ball by Kerry. She's really tightened the head down.
Julie doesn't want to make the head any bigger at the same time because Kerry's got a good close ball now. She's more than likely to attack with the third.
Close again.
Two green.
Still two. Worth playing inside the line with this one. A little bit of weight. Really nothing for being high of the jack. Being wide of the jack, that's a danger. But can afford it. Now the trouble in the forehand is if you play it a little bit narrow, you have to force the ball through. Was quite a bit of power. She's tried to play that with gentle weight, really. Just 2 or 3 yards.
It's a hard shot on here, isn't it?
Very difficult. I don't know on any of the forehands on the portable rink to play that weight. You have to be playing with great accuracy and a lot of confidence, to be fair. Julie doesn't have to come into this head.
She'll be running for a bit of cover at the back here. Cerianne makes contact. Could be two down.
Yeah, it's clever. Good ball. Good tactical knowledge. The jack could squeeze out if Kerry decides to go with more power. Probably worth it going with more power now. She'll be very unlucky to take her own out. It's possible, but desperately unlucky.
I think with two down anyway, I'd be playing a little bit more positive than her last, giving her myself a chance.
Back on the drawing line again. Trouble is you adjust the weight to arrive at the head and it just doesn't get back. You see what she's trying to play, the perfect shot, but quite often on the portable rink the success rate is low on that particular choice.
Yeah, she didn't add any pace with the last ball compared to her third, did she?
Two shots, Julie Forrest.
Francis Fletcher had indicated two shots, and that's exactly what it is.
0-2, first end. Jack length, 25 metres.
Another very good start from Julie Forrest.
A little bit of a bump on Julie's delivery. It's always been the same, hasn't changed over the years. Consistency's there, does it every single time, and that's what makes it so effective.
Two green.
Bump isn't always so obvious when you're playing on indoor carpets. In a lot of clubs, they've got a solid base or a solid wood base or a solid cement base, and on the portable rink, it makes a bit of a noise, but
everything's amplified in this environment because it's just so quiet. So
if you're walking past, you know who's playing, if Julie's on, and so, because you will hear that. But great players have done it before. Ian Bond, a fantastic player, and still has a little bumpy delivery.
Thing is, like you say, it really doesn't matter as long as it's the same every time, and deliveries, I suppose, don't have to look or sound pretty, do they?
Nope. Very good ball there by Kerry Glen.
Here she comes, just getting a little nibble of the jack on her way through.
Yes, that's brought her back balls into play. I think there's maybe just the one shot in it, but having said that, it's a nice turnaround, and she's got a chance to make it more if Julie fails. Sets of nine ends. Two of those and a three-end tie break. This looks narrow. You can't go fishing on the tight line because it just won't work. All the balls on the high side to push in, didn't want to be on the narrow side.
I think obviously her pace was quite conservative because you'd be aware that the Cerianne's balls are there waiting, so that's probably why she chose that pace. But yeah, like you say, just a little bit on the tighter side.
No, a chance. Kerry Glen just needs to turn the ball onto the jack to make it a three. If it goes further, she makes four. Certainly worth her trying to just draw another shot. You push the ball on the jack, it's a real bonus, but you must be up. Not on this occasion. I think you had the right idea with the line.
I'm sure Kerry Glen.
Yeah, shame, but she'll be happy to just be on the scoreboard and... It's just all about settling down
one,
in these
two,
games.
Two ends.
Cerianne Glen has won a lot of titles. A lot of titles in Wales before she moved to Australia to play there. Won a lot there as well. But came out of the club at Port Talbot in South Wales. John Price still lives there, and everybody that's watching in the bowls world will know John. He's not with us this week. Taking a break.
Length 26 metres.
That's where she started. Won a number of titles, can't remember how many, so obviously there's more than two or three. And the big move to Australia, which made all the difference in the world to her play. And some great titles there, Gold Coast singles, Queensland singles, Australian Open, the Golden Nugget singles, which is a Tweed Heads, it's a tough one to win.
She went out to Australia on the player pathway at the time, is that correct? Because she played for Australia, she represented Australia in the Commonwealth Games.
She did. It was. She went over there, played very well, brought into that pathway system, and did very well for them. Commonwealth Games silver medalist in Melbourne. I was in Darebin City, on the outskirts of Melbourne.
One red.
Julie Forrest hasn't really seen a lot of the outdoor top level play. I don't know why. She's a super player, especially on those fast greens down in Australia. Surprised she hasn't come into the frame for major honours on that. Might still happen. Still very much at the top of her game.
She played in a couple of World Outdoor Championships, Julie Forrest, back 96 and 2000. But that's probably the extent of the outdoor, and then focus more on indoor, I believe.
Yeah, it was. But the one that you really want to get is the Commonwealth Games, and we always thought Julie would get that at some stage. It's quite a while ago. I think she's a much better player now. She's got that experience.
Her indoor bowls club was recently renamed at the end of the last year after her.
Yes,
Julie Forrest
was.
Stadium.
Yeah.
And as a nod to all her many accolades and achievements. Yes. It's pretty cool.
Absolutely.
One
comes from Hoik in the Borders, Julie. Cerianne's title list continued actually back here in the UK after Australia. She won a number of titles here, but also has done well in the World Bowls Tour ones too. And previous winner of the singles back in 2008, then took a break off bowls for a long time, some 12, 13 years. Concentrate on career and family. Back playing again. Absolutely tons of experience from the Welsh lady.
They've never played each other before. I was speaking to Cerianne after. They've never come up against each other. Julie Forrest on a much flatter line here. She's close.
Gently on it.
What a great effort that was.
Oh, what an effort. Well, front touches are hard to beat.
Cerianne Glen.
Just as she didn't quite catch that jack full enough, not enough contact to drag it through to her waiting bowl.
Jack length 28 metres.
An immediate change of length, 28 metres. And that's just up the rink a little bit. Forrest has won the World Indoor Bowls Council, and now called the International Indoor Bowls Council Singles. A big event, that one. National champions from all over the world. She's won that five times. Qualified her to get here. Cerianne won the qualifier for this event in Scotland. Both made their way for the honour of playing on the portable rink the tough way through winning a lot of matches.
One green.
Good enough.
Good adjustment.
His backhand just holds on a line. As the weight drops off, it starts to dive right back into the head.
Got a little bit of extra pace. It's just if she can make a connection. It's unlucky.
Very unlucky. Toucher marked with the chalk. Everybody knows about that in the bowls world, of course. That's a live bowl if it goes in the ditch. Could be another one, but it's in a good place.
Two green.
Yeah, confirmed, two green. 30-second shot clock is in operation, so the players have to make sure they get the ball away within that time scale. But neither of them waste too much time on the mat.
To make a connection this time.
Very close.
Just going to dive. What a great effort.
Two touchers and I think she's still two down. Oh, what a wry smile.
Two green.
Yeah, she's been around the game long enough to know that another day you would have picked that jack up and made a two. I remember Cerianne when she was playing in Australia and top player. They were very keen to push through her citizenship to make sure she was part of that elite squad for the Commonwealth Games. Now, moved to the forehand, safer, but didn't really play it with any conviction.
Two shots, Julie Forrest.
Happy with the two, I think.
Yeah, with a smile sign. I'll walk away with that. I'll take that two.
Two unfortunate goals from Cerianne. She's quite happy to pick up the two there.
Yeah, two brilliant balls. They'll probably chat away in this game, Sean, because to be truthful with you, they've both been around the game a long time, and Cerianne's been there really for a very young age. Julie's been at the top for over 20-odd years. So a lot of respect for the amount of experience that they both have. But a distinct change in length again, so Julie going short length. Which surprises me a little bit considering the bowl she's using meters. Because they're a narrower running bowl. Normally you would play a longer length with a narrower running bowl, but she must feel she's getting a line.
She's come up the blocks very quickly, Julie Forrest, in this game.
Here's using a wider bowl. Taylor size 4. And Julie's is a Henselite. Tiger Evo, which is slightly narrower, let's put it that way, than certainly in the standard Tiger. And the size of ball she's using, size 3, for our connoisseurs that are watching in the bowls world.
Good bowling. Great opening two bowls again.
Two green.
Yeah,
This has got to be better.
One green.
Last call is a jack high.
Yes.
I'm surprised it's one. My chance of forehand here is a little bit of danger pushing the red ball in. But it's safer to get to the wide ball. Just needs to tap that down to make three. Deciding to go on the backhand because she's already played two really good balls on it. The front one might have scared her a little bit, but this is tentative.
I think Cerianne's being jack high. There wasn't a lot of danger on the backhand.
There was no conviction in it, though.
No.
She didn't really give it a chance on the perfect line, and the repeat of the last one with an extra foot of weight. Chance again.
Oh, she bend. This is a great ball. Got well it. Played.
And a drop. Well, if that's moved the jack, she might have made two.
She played that absolutely perfectly.
Yeah.
Little touch off the green. Sits down to flop onto the jack as well. Could be enough.
Just an extra foot of weight was always needed. And that's not easy to do in that portable rink. It's fairly quick out
one
there.
One shot, Cerianne Glen.
It's just the one. But it's a confidence-inspiring shot to make with your last delivery.
Set score 3-4 after 5-8. Jack length, 27.5 metres.
Still not full length yet. I thought you might have just pushed through for a full distance jack length. She needs to start winning this battle of the first two balls.
I feel like there's a game plan. She sort of already had in her mind where she wanted to play these jacks, Cerianne. That's a good start.
A repeat of the last one would be very helpful. Talking away to herself. I doubt her husband's watching, but I wonder if Dylan and Niamh are watching. Her two children.
Last bowl, 2 feet short of jack high.
Very close for this.
Great correction.
One green.
Last
ball from jack high is 10 inches.
Okay.
You can get round it, but there's an attacking shot in the forehand.
It's nicely framed too. It must look very tempting from the mat.
Here it comes.
She get down.
Not quite, not too far away. If I was Julie, I'd be very tempted to go deep with this one and make some sort of cover. Curley's daughter is here, Alex. She'll be watching this match with great interest. Well, sure, Julie. I think she was probably more worried about the ball disappearing, so she's popped another one in.
It's one of those, isn't it? It's either or, you know.
It is. And to be honest with you, it's not a bad choice because, you know, if Cerianne takes this out, Julie's still got a green ball in.
And she's got last ball.
And she's got last ball if the jack was through to the ditch.
Yeah.
And there's absolutely no reason why. Because
Cerianne has four timeouts remaining.
If she's looking at the ball there, you're going to get that clean on the angle. You're then going to come off through the gap. If you get the jack, well, it's perfect. You get the jack because you're straight back into the ditch with it.
Cerianne's just taking a timeout. Just give herself a bit of thinking space, but it's the same shot, isn't it?
It is. Ooh, I see. She's very close with this.
She's got it.
Well.
It did not come clean out of her hand, that one.
No, it did show its eyes a bit, and it's not the best result because of that. It wiggled and wobbled its way up the rink just a little bit. You know, you get those away clean, they're on the running surface. That jack looks like it might be staying in. Now, if it is, it looks like it is. We'll just check now. Oh, it's been lifted out of the ditch and on the re-spot. And that gives Julie Forrest an absolute mountain of room. You can see Cerianne, that wry smile of Cerianne there. You know, jack in the ditch was worth so much more. And she's probably two down.
I just think she didn't get it. She didn't get either the bowl or the jack full, did she? It rattled around a little bit.
Yeah, she came off her own bowl. If she had left that other red bowl in, it would have been the shot.
Yep.
But as it is, Julie adds another.
Yeah, good ball from Julie to make it, what do we think, three?
And it's the easiest shot she has all day. Unlucky, a costly end, but
well, it's tough when you're completely in the area and get the target, isn't it?
Yeah. Came out a bit odd, but straightened up and then took the red ball out. Now, if that red ball had stayed in, she would have got second shot out of that head on the re-spot. But because it came off the red ball, took it off the ring, got a half a jag instead of full jag.
I think that face said, give me a break, didn't it?
Yeah. Like it did, really. Come on, really?
Yeah.
You know, I've had other ends with two touchers and ended up losing twos. This time I've lost a three on a really good ball I've played.
They're both playing well. The standard of the heads has been very good. Which is what we love.
Well, yeah, that's what we expect. Chance. Yep. Good smooth delivery. So that last drive shot just didn't get away clean out of the hand, and it sort of.
It's easy to do.
It's very easy
especially
to do,
especially when you're playing quite a lot of pace.
So much effort going into making sure that you're pushing through the ball. Make sure you're on a good, tight, forceful line. Julie's better this one. Correction, number one shot.
One red.
She knows it's not bad, but it's not good enough.
Two
One red.
Just sneak past it, not quite.
That was the pressure ball, wasn't it? That was the one to get in really close, and she knows it. I don't mind. These reactions are good in many ways, you know, it's because the girls, both of them know when they've had their chances to do damage.
Yeah, I just think the line was a little bit optimistic for that. I think the weight was possibly good enough.
That's an interesting one. Julie's moved across onto the forehand after playing three on the other side. It looks like she's played one. Yeah,
very good ball.
Played it really well. And,
it's quite hard for Cerianne now too, because of her own shorter bowls.
The vast majority of people wouldn't change the last ball. The man who was the greatest of that I've ever seen and played against was David Bryant. He used to do that on a monotonously regular occasion. Three balls, maybe struggling with the three and maybe, but the next ball he'd change hands and draw the shot.
Well, it's a reset, isn't it? That's what I was going to say. I mean, Julie, she hadn't nailed it with any of those balls, so she's one down anyway, so I guess why not?
Trying to follow. Just passed. Good effort. That's a head that really Curry would be thinking, I should have won that head. I left too many chances to Julie.
Forrest. Set score 3-8 after 7 ends. Length 25 metres.
A little bit slow to come off the line. Big stickers on the balls. The old bolster stickers. Don't need them really because we're playing with green and your red balls, but it makes it a lot easier to see, I have to say.
I don't like bowling without stickers either, do you?
It doesn't disturb me too much, to be truthful, but we always appear to be using them for different things. I can't remember the last time I actually used a set of balls without stickers on.
Cerianne's good here.
Watching that some play balls, they're quite a heavy item. Certainly do not want to drop one on your foot or get crushed with a finger. We played that well.
Good enough, yeah. Came back. It was reluctant, it seemed, to come back. This is in the area. She's close. Needs to sit it.
Yep.
Yeah, well played.
Got it. Right with just an inch or two, which gives me the impression that ball's just a slightly bigger draw on it. Came back much better. Surprise, she was a bit tentative to that. Thought that would have been a bit more positive with two back balls.
Yeah, she definitely had the position there and it was worth just arriving, which is obviously the intention.
Well, we're always describing the perfect shot. Well, it's hard to make another one the forehand. She has to drop on her own ball. She could play the backhand because it's a swinging hand to get round the balls and drop in. That's a very safe option. Can't give the shot away on the backhand. Always a chance of being slightly over the weight in the forehand and moving the jack. Trouble is she's already played one on the forehand and played it well. Yep, there's the decision to play it again. Conscious of the fact she needs two.
Very close. Great ball. Well played.
Played that really well. That was not easy.
No, yep. There wasn't a lot of margin for error at all there.
That really was difficult to
play. Two shots, Cerianne Glen.
100% for effort and execution.
Score 5-8 after 8-10.
Really needed a double there because four down into the last end. Well, there's not too many fours that fly about in the last end when you really need them. A three, you've always got a chance. You're off to a good start with the first two balls. You've got a chance to make a three out of it. That's the first target. Try and half the set if you can.
Length 29 and a half metres.
It's the voice of Dan Blewett, the umpire. Follows the jack up, and of course, there's little white marks on the green indicate how many metres it is. So he's able to calculate exactly the length of the jack. White spot on the right hand side is for the re-spot position, that side of the rink. That's calculated by 3 meters from the ditch to the tee, and then you go across, find halfway, and you go back after that to 300 millimeters back, which is a foot, and that gives you the position of the re-spot. You really needed to know that, Sharon.
Oh, very precise, Corky. I'm quite impressed the way you just rattled that off there.
Yeah, it's. But, you know, everybody does it in a different way in terms of their competitions. They just bring it across after 2 meters and find a midway point. That's just the WBT way. And it works. Well, that's still good. Can't afford to be short, so it's good to be there. Always a chance.
Good bowl here. Yeah.
Good mixer.
One green and a measure.
Switching over hands with the view to trail the jack to her waiting bowls.
Yeah.
Just coming up short, unfortunately.
Being short doesn't help.
Not when you need a three minimum, no.
Julie can close this down. She'll want to do it with this bowl. Certainly doesn't want to have a three against her with one bowl to come. She'll want to close it with a third one. Try and get this set tucked away. Pushed it very wide for her bowl. Not the biggest swinging ball that you can play with, but she needs to get up past the red one. Oh, there's a chance.
Just took out the pace on that very wide line.
Yeah, there's a chance here. It's not an easy chance, but...
No, but it's nice to have it.
It is. Quite often you can face nothing to play, but...
Quite often you walk around the head thinking, oh, if... Yeah, no, there's nothing there.
Julie's walking down.
She's interested, her body language.
It's too heavy. It just wasn't getting back, that was the price. The weight probably wasn't bad, to be honest with you.
One shot, Cerianne Glen. First set, Julie Forrest.
It was just hard to get off that line. The weight wasn't bad, the trailer, to be fair.
So, Julie takes the first set.
Yes, I think she's been just the more consistent player, especially with the first two bowls.
The first two bowls have done a lot of damage. Certainly the first three, four ends, she was really on it. She came out strong and was putting Cerianne under pressure right from the outset.
So Jack is delivered, cast up the green. There's the dots. Meter apart.
Jack length 25 metres.
So the marker is able to centre the jack very quickly, and the umpire is able to tell us the length of the jack. All very slick, all very professional, all very precise.
Decent opener from Julie Forrest.
That's where the pressure starts.
One down.
This is good if it holds up. And you played that very well.
Yeah.
Just sneaked in that gap nicely.
A beautiful answer to a previous bowl against her.
Yeah. This bowl over here, relation to
Jack high, 20 inches short
touch
of jack
anything,
high.
Anything, little touch of the jack. Lovely. I can't imagine that looks that nice from the map now.
No, it's almost like you have to play into it to get the angle right. It's going to be hard to draw. You're looking for the gap.
Just giving this a chance. If she can get the same gap, which she has. Oh. What a bowl. What a bowl that was.
Wow.
Played that perfectly. That must look shocking from the mat. You can't even see the jack.
Too red.
Well, like I said, she had to arrive with a bit of weight, but finding the gap was absolutely brilliant. Because that would have been the first target, of course. There was nothing lucky about that. You play for the target. That was the gap. Played it beautifully. Now lies two good balls.
The pace was spot on. Is Julia up?
Oh, that's a mistake. She knows it because nothing behind the head to get out of trouble. Two down. Going to be another one down. In about 30 or 40 seconds. There's number three. Well, that's the one you have to beat because to draw the shot's difficult. But that one, a little bit far away, Julie will expect to beat that.
Slightly overplayed this, I think.
No. Wants to drop in though for third shot. Look,
it's not a disaster.
No, it wasn't a particularly tight, but it was awkward because the jack was coming off at the centre line.
Two.
So you had to find a new line. Both players did. And she lost the two. You know, they're chatting away about it, but
2-0.
You know, it was a brilliant ball to bring the jack through. Same as Julie as well.
Yeah, they played two good balls. Same bowl, really, wasn't it?
It was.
Found the gap, trailed the jack. I'd love to know what she's saying.
Yeah, she just chats away to herself.
Do you think it could be a mantra, though?
Well, it could be anything, you know, to be honest with you. Some players do chat away to themselves to try and get themselves motivated. I think the motivation is
a great tool to use.
Oh, absolutely. You know, it's. I know some players that just chat away to themselves just to keep themselves moving. It's not a particularly big issue with regards to motivation. If you're not motivated to be out there, you've got a problem. So that's not what it's for. It's all part of the concentration process. Some players use. Yeah, always look to be playing over it. Wider line.
Opportunity for Julie Forrest to really nail this.
Yeah, the margins are tight in terms of what your the margin of line that you've got is probably only about 6 or 8 inches wide. If you go wide of that track, You just don't come back, go under it, and you whiz away. Correction. Beautiful. Beautiful. Well, with that much experience with Cerianne Glen, you're sort of thinking, you know what, she's not going to play the wrong shot. Too much experience for that. And it's just a matter of making the corrections. That's all. And the same applies for Julie. There's too much experience out there to be playing the wrong shot. She's after it. Oh, I don't know. The red ball fell down. She got the ball and the jack instead of one or the other.
One red.
One red, yeah. That's confirmed by our rings. Chance here for Julie. There's a bad result available if she gets the ball onto Jack, because that's taking it towards all the red ones at the back of the head. But a chance to reach the red one.
Same boat as her last. She gets Cerianne's red ball solid. Could make a three. Well, feel like that's tighter.
Oh, she needs to reach with a lot of weight to hold this one. The weight was beautiful for the job, but just missed the line.
It's so punishing, isn't it?
It is.
One shot, carry on.
As I say, you're going fishing down that tighter line, and it's very, very hard to get it right.
Set score 3-0 after two ends.
Well, this is the start that the Welsh lady wanted. Flies down to Cardiff to play in the Women's Cardiff League down there, and that's a lot of commitment.
Representing Wales again in the internationals in March.
Well, the thing about someone like Cerianne isn't, yes, she's been out of the game for a while, one of our younger viewers, but don't dismiss that amount of titles and experience. You welcome it back into the fold, and that's what they've done.
Last ball short, 20 inches.
slipping through the gap there.
Balls and gaps. You know you have to reach after the first one being short, but you just hope to connect with something. In the meantime, your opponent's banging more balls in the head.
That's a good bow there.
Not getting back. Cerianne started to move right away.
Cerianne just looking to beat that bowl of Julie's. Cover and count if she can.
This is a big chance. It really is. She's 3-0 up, 2 on the rink, another one to arrive. Got a back bowl. Interesting, she's playing the backhand here. Trying to get the two green ones. She's trying to get cover, but at the same time, score a third. Interesting choice of shot. She could have played the forehand and turned the jack around the corner to hide it.
It's safer down the backhand, I guess.
Always lots of ways to play it. But that's a clever ball. It's not going to score, though. But it's
that's
a clever
ball.
Yeah. And tactically, the both of them are playing very, very well.
Well, yeah, and she's saying to Julie, come on then, what you got? Julie's closer if she's got the pace. Is she here?
It's trying to creep up, but it's struggling. If it stays up, she may have made second.
One shot, Cerianne Glen.
Took one off. 4-0's not
a
crisis situation, but it's building. Julie Forrest will be thinking, I need to score the next end to try and keep in touch here. Well, we had a feeling this was going to be a quality match.
Yeah, it's been great so far. Really tight heads, and it's been changing quite a lot as well.
Jack length, 26 and a half metres.
You know, if Cerianne hadn't taken that break off the sport, no doubt the titles would have been racking up as well.
She says that she really missed bowls, which is part of the reason that, you know, the main part of the reason that she's come back. She genuinely missed it, missed the people, and missed the actual sport.
Well, there's choices to be made sometimes. Career, family. It does also mean you can come back in. I took a break from the outdoor game for quite a while.
And you're never going to be too old, are you?
Well, I don't know. Sometimes I wonder. Indoor internationals, we played 2 matches in 1 day, over 8 hours of play.
That shouldn't be a problem for you.
It actually wasn't, to be honest with you. Strangely, it wasn't. But I missed the banter and the crack with the guys, and the outdoor game in particular was just you have that club. Closeness of that club, and you've played at my club at Belmont, so you know what it's like. It's a great club to play in.
I think if you're competitive and you suddenly take that out of your life, there's going to be a gap, isn't there, however you slice it.
Yeah, there is. Needs to rest into the front ball and drop.
Ooh, one red.
Not quite. Quality balls, though.
This has got to be a good line.
Julie's chatting away to herself there. She's giving herself a little bit of a telling off.
Timeout called. Cerianne has 2 timeouts remaining.
She knew she could afford to reach that. There's absolutely no reason to be dropping on the short side, but you can't get them all perfect.
Cerianne will be looking to just turn around the corner if she can, just take the danger away. She's on a flatter line.
Yeah, but more weight.
Yeah, slightly over.
Didn't want to hit that on the edge. A lot deeper than what I thought she was going to play. Maybe trying to get the green ball out clean.
I think with that pace it must have been.
Must have been a deep ball.
No, I mean, I think she must have been trying to take the ball out. I think so.
Well, maybe it was a double shot, you know. If you miss it, you get a good back one.
Yeah, the options were there. And there are still gaps.
Certainly reaching this time, but
yeah,
needs the jack.
She's going to get the gap. Oh, goodness.
That could hurt, because that might be 2 shots. She's just given another one away, I think. And that will hurt.
She's really unlucky.
Yeah, very unlucky. It must be 2.
Just coming in here and just feathering the jack rather than catching it clean.
Well, those are the sort of things that can happen whenever you're forced to play the shots. She did well to get that close with a couple of metres of running, a couple of yards. I'm sorry for changing between yards and metres for anyone who's watching, but the rink is laid out in metres, and quite often the instructions that come from the markers will be in metres. But the vast majority of people who play bowls, club level, even international level, will still use the old imperial yards.
Yeah, it's just one of those funny things, isn't it? Even the younger players, you hear them saying in yards, and it just doesn't really make sense.
No, because they've been educated in metres.
Exactly, and I'm in that category. And I wouldn't talk about yards in any other realm of life. Just on the bowling green.
Just on the bowling green, exactly.
Bizarre.
It's just common practice. Once again, slightly longer jack length, 28 metres. And that tee mark is 3 metres from the ditch, which is different to club level.
Let's start again.
Sian, as you know, it's different from club level, so outdoor in particular as well, still working on the 2-meter line, 2-meter tee. It's not a bad ball there. There to be touched in. Julie misses her line.
One red.
I think Cerianne stepped up, Cerianne Glen, with those first two balls in this set. Putting a lot more pressure on.
Yeah, she's really taken control of this second set.
Julie's starting to look for the big ball, third delivery, fourth delivery.
I think Cerianne's just been building slightly better heads for herself than in the first as well.
Just needs to slide the front ball, and that's where the danger was. I was saying about that ball being a good one. For Cerianne, that was her second delivery, and just dropping short like that. It was always ready to be pushed in.
Effort that was.
It is, but she's lined two shots, and you know, Julie still once again has to play a big ball to save shots, never mind to get shots. It's, don't get me wrong, look, it's still there, and she can make it. If anything, she'll be looking to reach into her green ball and flop across onto the red.
Yeah, there's a shoulder there, isn't there?
There is, rather than go for the.
She can catch it.
The gap is there too, but you want that shoulder because you're rocking in towards the jack off the edge. Struggling to get back off the line with a narrower ball. Yep. And that's where it becomes difficult when you've got a ball that just doesn't bend as much. Trying to play those little overweight shots to the back. Cerianne Glen is taking full control now of the second set.
Julie has three timeouts remaining.
8-all after five.
Jack length, 26 and a half metres.
Time for Julie Forrest to step in and take control. Failed to do that, so I expect Cerianne to make the adjustment.
Thank you.
No.
How short am
I? Just over 3 feet.
That's a rare error, and you can see a reaction as well to that.
As expected, Julie Forrest getting in with her second. Just ask the question, doesn't it? It's not the closest bowl, but it's good enough at this stage.
It is. It's a jack-high ball to be caught as well. You can see this ball whizzing back into the centre of the rink. That was actually from a pretty high line, so still got a chance. Needs to really rest up to the jack high ball, even ease it away a little bit, come in behind the jack. That's not going to help. That really, really should have been a two.
Cerianne was let off slightly there, I think.
Doesn't want to get the green ball.
So she played it very well.
Oh, yeah, that was it.
Great ball.
Too many chances in the end, just too many chances. Nothing really close to the first three. Bangs one on up with the last one. Needed to be closed down before that. Gonna have to change to the forehand now.
Looks decent. She's got the jack. Very good ball.
Brilliant ball. That was the recovery one that we've been talking about before.
Great reply. Down it comes. Little touch of the jack.
That's fine. Yeah. Two.
Two it is.
Two shots, Julie Forrest.
Great turnaround.
Needed the score that end. Really had the score. Still a long way to go to get back into this set. Six behind with three ends to go, but losing that one would have been pretty disastrous.
Chat length, 24 metres.
going to get the shot, but it's coming to a very good home just behind.
Gives her options as well.
It does, and this one needs to be really good because that head's just too open.
Yeah, it's crying out to be changed. A lot flatter.
Well, not where she wanted
it. Too green.
I know Julie a very long time, and I know the reaction, just how annoyed she is. May not always show it, but you can tell. Oh my, overcorrected. This is massive for Julie Forrest now. Absolutely massive. Don't think about the four. She has to think about just getting another bowl in,
mm-hmm.
put the pressure on.
In the area.
Well, this is better. Yeah.
Much better. It's a bit of an unfortunate finish.
Yeah.
Her ball just sitting back down. It's quite the target.
Exactly. We're saying it was better because look at this. Touch the jack. She flops in behind the jack, leaves a big gap, but the ball flops against the bias and leaves a massive catch.
Time out call.
Well, these are where games are won and Cerianne lost.
Has one timeout remaining.
This needs to be a good one. Do you want to get back from the high line?
No.
That's a bad count after a two.
Four shots, Julie Forrest.
Full house of four, Julie Forrest. From 8-0 down, is suddenly within touching distance in the second set.
Set score 8-6 after seven ends.
8-6.
That's quite the turnaround, isn't it? Just, yeah. That shot, I mean, it must have looked really nice, but we know they're not as easy as they look. It's easy for us.
Well, to be fair, in a lot of clubs, you would just go down and play that. But the portable rink has its little quirks. You just put a little bit extra on, and it's so hard to get back. But you know if you nip it, it's just going to dive away. So I can understand that. Give it a chance. Just too much on the high side. And Julie Forrest, well, never really looked like picking up a four in this set.
Track length, 25 and a half metres.
Cerianne Davis, or Cerianne Glen, I still think of her as Cerianne Davis, but Cerianne Glen plays at the Curtiston Bowls Club, West Lothian, the outdoor club. And she tells me they're known locally as the Cheese Town Boys.
Do you want to elaborate on that?
Nope.
Okay.
I'm sure someone somewhere will give us a full explanation, but if not, I'll try and find out.
You can't come with half the information, Corky.
There's got to be an explanation of the thing. It has to be.
It wasn't quite right out of her hand.
You don't normally hear a bump with Cerianne's ball. She gets the ball away one pretty green. Smooth and didn't get it away clean. That's finished. That doesn't make it easy. I'm going. Yeah, she's attacking it. Oh, has she? Yeah, she turned her back on it right away. Julie's got the best back ball here, so I just wonder what she'll do. And the reason I'm saying that is with line two, eight all, she gets two.
I think I'd be drawing it down the forehand because I'd be leaving that as it is for Kerry to hit. If I can count with a third.
The thing about a third ball is that she has, as you said, trying to get the third, she's got that cushion going into the last end.
Yes, it helps, doesn't it? Psychologically, it's much better to go.
Yeah, well, she's playing what you said for the third sham, but she played it in the backhand.
Yeah.
Candice, she's been very comfortable on in this end.
It's a perfect bowl.
Even if the two of them disappear, she could score single. But a two and a four, and now she's lying a three.
The dynamic has totally changed over the last three ends, hasn't it?
Yeah,
it's
called. Cerianne has no
Julie
time
now holds the cards.
If she wants to put herself into a very strong position going into the last end, she has to draw this. Cerianne Glen has to draw the shot. If she wants damage limitation, she could play in, bowl on the ball, bowl on the jack, reduce it to one, but still needs to win the next end.
Is she going to draw it or play it?
Well, if she wants the shot, she has to draw it. Very good line with this. A really good line.
It's a great effort, whatever happens.
Took one off.
Yeah.
Well,
two shots, Julie Forrest.
Thing is, even if she'd have just taken one, or lost one. She still has to win the last end, anyway.
She does.
So, good call, good effort. Good call for her to try and draw the shot, but she knew, with all of her experience, to get the number one, she had to draw it. My goodness me, from 8-0 to 8-all. Three ends.
Length 24 metres.
A little purple flower in the hair. Now, who's going to get the really close ball first? Don't think this one's going to make it.
One red.
Oh, short, Kelly. Cerianne's ball to the jack, please.
15 inches short of jack high.
Yeah, that's beatable. No point in running the ball off, really. It's just too much. Too much room.
Too many gaps.
Yeah.
To go flying through.
But heavy with this.
Not much, is she?
Yeah, just drifting through.
Another chance for Cerianne.
Ooh. Pressure's telling in this end a wee bit because...
Yeah, it's looser than all of their previous ends.
This is doing. Might be second shot. It's important if it is second shot because Julie might have been thinking just to take the ball out and saying, well, you know, I'm happy enough. It's only the one. I wonder, will she decide to drive the jack or drive the ball out and say, well, okay, you've got 2 feet to draw it. It's too much room, I think.
I'd expect to see Julie Forrest trying to draw this.
Yeah, that would be her normal game to draw it. Really would be.
Timeout call.
Different if it was the last ball of the
Julie
end.
Julie has 2 timeouts remaining.
Last ball of the end. Couldn't be at all, so she played the weight shot. Difficulty is if she gets the jag and doesn't stay with it, there's a mountain of room at the back. Going for the draw. Needs to adjust the weight. The line was good, and I still think this is over. Looks too heavy.
Very similar to the 2 and 3.
Oh, that's a long way away.
One shot in the second set. Cerianne Glen, match tie break.
Well, Cerianne read good. She didn't need to play a particularly good ball to win the set in the end, but it was enough.
It's interesting, that set. It really changed very quickly.
But there were effectively 3 chances to beat a ball that was a foot away, 15 inches away. So the chances were there.
They selected to take the jack on the first end.
Rules change. Tiebreak ends. 3 ends. You just have to win 2 of them. It's a Langham Glass Trophy. And that's a big one, as they say. Cerianne won the toss, decided to take the jack. So that means she has a choice of jack, first and third. She wants to go for the different jack length, probably longer. Yes, it is. It's a longer jack length than what Julie's been playing.
27 metres.
27 to match up a little bit. Get the oxygen into the lungs here. Get a good first ball.
Yeah, you want to be piling the pressure on, don't you? As quick as you possibly can.
tricky one.
One red, last bowl.
Force Julie to switch over.
Just in by half a ball. Julie can't afford to be short here because touch her own ball. If she falls through, it's still good. Looks a little bit heavy, is it? No, it's a little bit heavy, but it might just make it back again. That's close.
One green.
One green. Played it well. It's worth attacking this, you know. Interesting to see what she plays. Just playing the draw.
She lifts her own ball once or slips past it. Couple of options there. Sit on her own back red.
Yeah, she needs to make a connection though.
She's got a very good ball here.
Oh, beautiful draw.
Just played that really well.
Yeah, just had to make it past the front one.
One red.
Just got it full enough to sit, didn't it?
Yeah. Surprised Julie's drawing this. Thought she might have played more weight. Because if she'd got into the jack to bring it out to the re-spot, she has the last bowl. Oh dear. Oh, she didn't get that away, I could tell. Oh dear, now she's in trouble. Bad ball.
Cerianne's got the back.
Timeout call.
Slightly, just got the back position too.
Cerianne has no timeouts.
She played the same
remaining
ball as her last. What'd you say, Cerianne?
Yeah, you know, it depends what she thinks. Does she think it's close enough to win the end? Thinking, well, Julie might just play a runner and hope to get a result. Play it on the re-spot, cover things.
I think the run is tricky. It doesn't look very appealing. It's hard not to clip that jack.
Let's just see if she is going re-spot deep. Looks like it. Yeah, it's not bad. Maybe a bit further than what she wanted, because I still think the jack can go out there if she plays the runner. Things just asking about the timeouts, and she had five from the previous two sets. They're used up, and she used an extra one in the tie break.
Timeout call.
Just used it a moment ago, so she's out of those. Still think it's worth Julie playing a runner at this. I really do. You can get a result.
Yep. Bolt.
And the run through, and the wow!
Very nearly had it there.
Oh, that would have been outrageous. That would have been outrageous. She looked a bit wide, out of hand.
Julie has two timeouts remaining.
We've seen worse happen though.
Just catching her own short bowl, but getting the run through, picking up the jack. That could have been devastating, couldn't it?
A thin edge on the jack on the way through. She was getting the shot.
Yep.
Well, Julie has said to Cerianne, you go ahead and play the jack. I want the last bowl again. So fair enough. We might be in a position where this match is over this end. Good solid connection on her own ball will help. Just like that. Tempted to run this.
I think so, yeah.
Ball or jack?
Deal with it early in the end.
It's
a hold.
Away. Yeah, it's diving away. Wasn't far away, but I think she knew herself that was just going to go. It's a run for cover here, I would have thought.
My ball in relation to jack high, please.
Your shot bowl?
Yeah, yeah.
2 inches short of jack high.
Strong position though. Line two shots. One disappears, you're still line game. And a chance to put a back ball in. You've also got the re-spot covered.
Yeah, she played that very well. She really likes it, I think.
Better this time. That's going to go off, so that'll go on the re-spot. Not the best result, but there's always a possibility. Would have been far better going the other side because she had the re-spot on the other side. And this is not going to look good when this jack goes on. Yeah, that's...
Three red.
Just have to score one, not three. Just needs a closer ball, though. The one she wanted.
Yeah, good ball.
That's going to be very hard to beat. This is a hard one. Do you draw within 6 inches after playing a weight shot?
Two weight shots.
Well, two weight shots for the overcorrection is very possible. Or do you go again and hope to get the jag into the ditch?
Julie has one timeout remaining.
It's no good if she puts it off the side of the ring. It'll just go back on the re-spot. It's no good if you take one out because there's, what, four against you?
Yeah.
I think I might go for the jag here because I think it's a very hard shot to play.
I think go again too.
Pick your weight, hope to get the result. Just too
slightly
wide.
Slightly wide.
Yep.
Second end of the match, Cerianne Glen.
A fascinating game, no doubt about that. Tremendous ball line at times. Opportunities for both players to win the match. But great respect from two very, very experienced and top quality bowlers. Well, on this occasion, it's Cerianne Glen. Welsh player who now lives in Scotland.
Another fantastic match.
Has taken out Julie Forrest in the first match of the Women's Match Play Championship.
Well, there we have it, ladies and gentlemen. What a fantastic game that was between Cerianne and Julie Forrest there. Nip and tuck all the way through, one set each. I thought maybe Cerianne was just going to let Julie back in that second set. But hey-ho, it was a tie break and it was all down to Cerianne. So let's have a look what we're coming for today then. Let's have a look. So 7:30 this evening is Alison Merrion MBE takes on the qualifier all the way from Australia, which is Lisa Featherby. I really hope you've enjoyed the first three games of today. So until it's this evening, a very goodbye for now.